Hi, I'm Graham Martin with Prudential Northwest Properties, and I'm here today with Jesse Fox of Harbor Services. Jesse here and his crew, they're actually in the midst of doing a major repair job in the form of replacing stringers on a floating home. So Jesse, I'd like you to be able to explain a little bit how this process works on doing such a major job like this.
Usually, first of all, what happens is a float inspector like John Glenn comes down and inspects the float to tell us exactly what needs to be repaired. And at that point, I come down and give an estimate on those said repairs. The jobs usually take between 3 and 4 weeks. It's a process of coming down in preparation with my equipment and barges. We'll come up next to the house and start prepping, which is including crawling underneath the house and preparing spots for the new stringers to go. And after the new stringer spots are then dapped, a major part of the project is pulling the house out from the dock in order to get the full-length beams all the way through underneath the house. That's about a one-day process, but it's pretty intense because all the utilities need to be disconnected and reconnected, and plus we don't want the house to float away. So it's a little tricky, but after that process, is the house is put back in, then we come back and shim up the stringers with weather-resistant material and pin them with large pins. And this sometimes has to go through the floor. In a lot of cases, we're able to make small openings into the floor, but if it's inside, let's say, the living room or the kitchen, the floor covering sometimes is compromised, so we can get these pins through there. After the house has been reshimmed and pinned, then it's just a matter of putting everything back together.